Howdy! In this video, we will discuss how to enable the override grade column in the Canvas Gradebook, as well as how to override a student's grade in Canvas or through an Excel sheet. Prior to using the override column, please make sure you have done the following in your gradebook: reviewed and enabled a grading scheme for your course, reviewed your gradebook to ensure grades have been entered properly. This includes confirming assignment weights and group rules are correct. Reviewed late and missing submissions and entered zeros if necessary. Confirm that all grades are posted and visible to students. Reviewed the total column in the Canvas gradebook to ensure that you want to use the override column to send to Canvas. To enable the override grade column, start by clicking on the grades link in your course navigation pane. Click on the gear icon in the top right corner. Click the Advanced tab and check the box labeled Allow Final Grade Override. Click Apply Settings in the bottom right corner. You should now see the override column as the far right column in your gradebook. The override column may be used in your gradebook if you would like to manually curve or modify the existing grade in the total column. This column will accept a letter grade using the existing grading scheme. If a grading scheme is not enabled, you will get a warning that it is not a valid grading scheme. The grade submission feature in Howdy will use the override column if it is added in your course gradebook. To override a grade directly in Canvas, simply locate the student you would like to change the letter for and enter the letter grade in the corresponding box. In this case, I will be curving the test student from a B to an A. It is important to note that if you use the override grade column, you must enter grades for every student, regardless if they will be curved or not. Howdy will only use the total column or the override column, so each column needs to be fully filled out. In my case, I need to enter the other grades manually. If you enable the override column for midterm grades, you will be able to manually enter or modify the final grade, use a CSV to modify the final score to reflect the course grading scheme, or turn off the override column for the final grade submission. If you would like to use Excel to manage your grades, you have the ability to create a column for grading that can be imported into Canvas and convert to the applicable grading scheme. On the top left of the gradebook, click Actions. Then click Export. When the export is completed, Canvas will download the CSV file automatically to your computer. Open the file that was downloaded. Locate the column that is titled Override Score. You may need to expand column titles to ensure that you're looking at the right title. Notice, though, that the Override Score column is the only column that is not read-only. Enter the new grade in a numerical format, such as 97, 89, or 75, and make sure that it reflects the course grading scheme. If you would like, you can also have Excel calculate a manual curve for you utilizing its formulas. For example, I can have Excel locate the unposted final score column that has the numerical value, manually add 2 to the grade, and then pull that formula down to apply it to the rest of the students. Canvas will convert this number in the override score column once it's imported back to Canvas. When you have finished manually adjusting the grades, save the CSV file to your computer. You can do this by clicking File, Save As, and locating the file location you would like to save it. In this case, I will save it to my documents. Once you've saved the file, go back to your Canvas gradebook, select Actions, and select Import. Select Choose File, and locate the file where you saved it previously. In my case, I saved it under Documents. Select the file and select Open, and then Upload Data. Once the upload is complete, you will see this window where you have one last chance to verify that the grades are accurate. Once you verify that the grades are accurate, click Save Changes. You will be redirected back to the Canvas Gradebook, where you will notice that the override column has the updated letter grade. For example, in my case, Jobin was given 2 extra points, which gave him the B in the override column. If there are any discrepancies in these letter grades, we are happy to help. Email the Office for Academic Innovation at aihelp@tamu.edu, and we are happy to assist with ensuring your grades are accurately submitted to Howdy. For more information, training, and resources, please visit lms.tamu.edu. Thanks, and gig 'em.